think I have found the greatest way to buy your next RV. Hey all, RoamTownGirl here. And if this is your first time visiting my channel, welcome! It's so lovely to have you. And if you're one of my longtime watchers, mwah, 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 you know I so appreciate that you keep coming back. In today's video, what I have been wanting to share with you is I think I have found the best way to buy a used RV. It truly was a fantabulous experience. And for those of you shopping, I wanted to throw this in the mix because you might want to consider purchasing your next RV the same way I did. And I know when I'm ready to get another RV, I'm probably going to buy it the exact same way. So the way that I bought this RV, I did not have to deal with private parties, dealerships, and certainly not the prices that come with a new RV. So first, let's do a little backstory. Romeo Fancy Pants behind me here, he's not my first RV, he's my second. And when I bought my first RV, I did buy it private party. And if you've watched those earlier videos, you know that I am fond of saying that there is a special place in hell reserved for the guy who sold me Scout. Now, I love Scout to death, but I certainly got taken. The guy that sold it to me, I don't know, maybe he saw my blonde hair and my gender and knew that there's a sucker born every minute. And Scout wasn't even my first RV purchase. I had actually bought an RV prior to that, only I never even took possession of that one. It had a few problems. One was the generator, and the guy promised me he could fix it, and after a few weeks, nothing was happening. He was getting irritated with me, I was getting aggravated with him, and in the end, we just decided that it would be best if I returned the title to him and he refunded me my money. So I do admit, I have been burned buying RVs secondhand private party, which is why I am just not a fan of doing it that way. And if I can at all avoid that, I will. So what is this fabulous way of buying a used RV that I want to share with you? Why, it's buying a retired rental. Now wait, from a specific rental company, and I'll tell you why. So I bought Romeo Fancy Pants from El Monte RV, and I'll admit, I have a very warm and fuzzy spot in my heart for El Monte RV because when I started this whole RV adventure, I had never even driven an RV or camped in an RV. And so I rented one, and there was an El Monte RV in Las Vegas, and that's where I rented my first RV. And so it just tickled me to be able to buy a future RV from them. I think their company's great, both as a rental company, and now I'm gonna tell you how I also think that they're fabulous as a sales company. Now, El Monte RV has rental offices all across the United States. So if you ever wanna rent from them, you've got a ton of locations to choose from. Their sales locations are not as many, but I think they are located in sort of the prime RV areas. Northern California and Southern California. In California. You've got McKinney, Texas. You've got Orlando, Florida. Oh! Oh, and I forgot. Las Vegas, Nevada. So let's go into my 8 reasons why I think buying a used RV from El Monte RV is the way to go. Okay, so here they come in no particular order. Number 1, the age. I can't speak for other RV rental companies because I don't really know a lot about them. But what I do know about El Monte RV is that they retire their RVs after 2 years. So when you buy a used RV from them, you're going to get one that is a couple years old. So not only is it wonderful to have a newer RV, but that rolls into number 2, the mileage. So when I bought Romeo here, he had 31,000 miles on him. Number 3, no haggling. They have a no haggle price. They just charge what they charge. No negotiation necessary. And I love that concept. I call it the grocery store concept. You walk in, it is what it is. You either pay that price or you don't pay that price. End of story. Love it. Number 4, price. that no haggle price is substantially lower than what you would pay for that same RV if you were buying it from a dealership or specifically private party. So I have no problem being fully transparent with you. When I bought Romeo here, he's a 2019 Thor, Four Winds 30D bunkhouse model. I paid $50,000 for him, $49.95. When I looked up how much private parties were selling this exact same RV for, it was $65,000. So right off the bat, I was saving $15,000. One of the trade-offs of buying a used rental, of course, is that it's not in pristine condition. In fact, it took me 4 tries to get one that wasn't too beat up. So I kind of call them gently used. But hey, for a $15,000 price differential, I'll take a few scuffs. How about you? So it might take a little extra effort. You might have to see multiple units. If you were in California, you might go to multiple locations. So it might make it a little bit of a hassle and inconvenient, but for a $15,000 price differential, I don't know, for me, totally worth it. Hey, before I go on, would you mind terribly doing me the favor of giving this video a thumbs up? I sure would appreciate it. Number 5, the financing. Although I didn't need to take advantage of this, I want you to know that they have in-house financing available. I can't speak to how fair or competitive their rates are, but I do know it's available, and I do know from other people that when you're trying to get a loan, especially on a used RV, a lot of times, not so easy. So it's nice to know that that is an option that's available for you. Number 6, the service history. It behooves El Monte RV to keep their RVs in tip-top shape so that they can keep them out on the road and renting them, which means that they are serviced regularly, and when you purchase one, you get all the service records. So I was able to see exactly what had been going on with this guy for the past 2 years. And that's something you can't always count on when you buy from a private party or a dealership, right? Number 7, the shakeout. When you buy a brand new RV, it's not uncommon over the first year to 2 years that you are going to discover every single thing that the factory did not do correctly. And you are going to be in and out of service with all these warranty issues. That's the shakeout when you have a brand new RV. When you buy a used RV from either a dealership or a private party, it's going to depend on what has been going on with that RV. If it's been sitting in storage for a while or in someone's garage, again, all the systems that have gotten a little fatigued either by overuse or lack of use, you're going to have a fun time going through and watching all those come up and fixing all of those. And that was one of the reasons I had such issues with Scout. Scout's shakeout went on and on and on. And I think when I finally just sold Scout a few months ago, I had finally reached the point of working out all the kinks, and he was finally a dream. And number 8, the support. This was sort of an unexpected surprise, being that he's a used RV that is from an RV rental company that has a service department. I was able to strike up a relationship with the service manager, and they have just been all kinds of helpful. So one of the first issues I had with Romeo here was the slide. This slide in particular, with the bunkhouse, was not going in and out easily. I was making lots of friends in RV parks because he wouldn't close all the way and I'd have to go find someone to help me push him the rest of the way in. Anyway, they said, "Where are you? If you're nearby, bring the RV over," which I did. And it turned out, of course, nothing was wrong with the slide. User error. They told me I couldn't put so much stuff on the 2 bunk beds, which really kind of aggravated me because that was sort of the whole reason why I bought this model. I mean, when I saw those 2 bunk beds, I started drooling over the extra storage space I was going to have. And I had looked up that each bed can support 150 pounds of weight. So I had every reason to think, as long as I stay under that 300 pound mark, which I was well under, I should have no issue with that slide. Yeah, not exactly the case. As was said to me, "Kim, Think about it. Those are bunk beds. Yes, each one can support 150 pounds of weight. But when people are opening and closing those slides, there aren't any people in the beds, are there? Minor detail. And of course, I have since found a workaround for that, but let's stay on point here. So going back to support, the other way they have been most helpful is because they rent these RVs, they are completely used to people going off, not knowing how this unit works, having all kinds of problems, calling in with their issues, and then on the phone, they're just able to tell them how to fix it. So an example was my refrigerator. The first time I boondocked, and I was therefore switching from being plugged in electric to running it on propane, my refrigerator wouldn't engage. So I panicked for half a minute, and then I thought, oh, I'm gonna call El Monte RV. So I called them. I spoke to the guy that answered the phone. I just said, hey, are you one of the people that does the walkthrough when people rent these things? Yep. I said, awesome. I said, my refrigerator won't go on and it's in propane mode. It worked fine in electric mode. And bippity boppity boop, he told me how to reset it. It worked like a charm. So come on now, we all know you're not going to be able to call up the dealership and do that, let alone a person who sold it to you private party. So I just can't say enough about that. After about a month, I got a package in the mail, and it was this fantastic little zippered package of my owner's manual, extra keys, resources for Thor. I mean, I just am so tickled with how my whole experience went. And by the way, El Monte RV doesn't just rent and sell Class C's, they also do Class A's. So if I've done a good job of turning you on to this idea, you can just go to the El Monte RV website and you'll see a place where there's links for rentals, but also a link for their inventory that's for sale. And that's what I plan to do when I move on from Romeo Fancy Pants over here, which is I'm just gonna keep watching the inventory. And when I see a make and model that I like and a year that I can afford, then I will probably be looking into getting another RV. Well, I hope I've brought something to your attention that you hadn't thought of before. So if you had a good time with me today and you'd like to do it again, be sure to subscribe to the channel and hit that bell notification so you'll get notified the next time I post another video. Supposedly. I don't know. YouTube kind of is wonky on that. So what do you think of this idea? Is it something you might consider for yourself? If it is, let me know in the comments below. You know, I love hearing from you guys. All right, I got more videos coming specific to the RV, things like the things I love, the things I must have, the things I hate, so stay tuned for those. See you next time.